Don't you absolutely hate it whenever you have blank box art in your game lists in RetroArch and the automatic updater doesn't seem to fix it? Especially when you're just scrolling quickly and looking at all the nice thumbnails and there are these random holes everywhere. It's not very aesthetically pleasing, and I'm sure it seriously bothers anyone with OCD. But let's take a quick look at RetroArch thumbnails and see why this happens and how we can fix it. Hey guys, Watsonator here. I had somebody ask me about missing box art recently, and I know I personally run into it all the time when dealing with RetroArch, so I figured I'd go ahead and make a little guide. If this is your first time using RetroArch, go check out my startup guide on how to get everything set up before watching this one. I will link to it in the top right above my head right here. So this is a fresh copy of RetroArch I have installed to the desktop just for the sake of this video. The only thing I have done is change the layout to the XMB style, and go ahead and add a PlayStation 1 and NES core and a few games to go along with it just for examples for the video. So as you can see right here, I have my game lists in here already, and I have not yet added box art, so I'll go ahead and show you how to do that right now if you're unaware. Come right over here, go to the online updater and the playlist thumbnails updater. It should list your game lists right here. So I'll go ahead and do that for the two lists I have. If you have really long game lists, this may take a while to add the thumbnails for. That's totally normal. Now we see that it added the thumbnails for my games. A little trick I can tell you, if you hit the X button on an Xbox controller or the square button on a PlayStation controller, it will actually cycle through the type of thumbnail that it shows. So it goes from showing box art to an in-game screenshot to the main menu screen. And so that's very handy if you're kind of like looking through a long list of games and you're like, what in the world is that game? So that's a nifty little trick. But as we look through my list here, as we're going down, we see that, my Super Mario Bros. 2 and 3 don't have a thumbnail. What do I do? Well, first go ahead and try to download the thumbnails individually again. Sometimes it might miss it if you do it with a whole bunch of other games. So try that first. As you can see, that did nothing. So it's important to know where RetroArch pulls these files from, the thumbnail files. And that's actually from a giant database that is online. I will be sure and link to it in the description down below. It's an important website to bookmark if you're going to be adding missing thumbnails, because you will need to reference it. Now it looks just like this. Let me go ahead and make it bigger so you can see it. And you'll be greeted by a long list of gaming platforms here. And within those gaming platforms are all the games. And then if you click on an individual game, you will see the box art for that title. Now we want the NES. So the name of your game in RetroArch needs to match up with the name of the game in this database, or it won't know where to pull the thumbnail from. So if we look at the NES, and you'll see right here, it shows box arts, snaps, and titles, which corresponds to that setting where we're just cycling through the in-game screenshot as well as the main menu screen. Those are the three settings right here. So all I care about today is box art. We're going to go down to Super Mario Brothers 2 and 3 right there, and we'll see that none of these Super Mario Brother entries match with these over here. You'll see that it says like revision A, and none of that is listed here. And that's why it doesn't bring in the thumbnail, because it doesn't match up. So all we have to do is change the name that it displays in RetroArch to match up with this one. It's that simple. So you can come right in here and just rename it here. I think it's easier to go over to the desktop menu and then to the game we're trying to edit, which are the Super Mario games here and here. So all you have to do is right click and hit edit, and then it pulls up this box where you can change the name. Keep in mind, we're not changing the actual path name or the file name, just the name that it is listed as under RetroArch. So right here, I'm just gonna actually take this revision off. There was a listed Super Mario Bros. 2 USA just like that. So I just match it up to that, and I'm gonna do the same thing for 3. Match it up to that right there. And if you're wondering how I got this title, again, it's just from the database. If you look right here, I'm just matching it up to this one right here and this one right here. And if you want to know what image it's going to be displaying, you can just click on it. That should be the image that it shows. So now that I have that in there, I'm just going to exit out and update it individually again. Super Mario Bros. 2, download thumbnails. Super Mario Bros. 3, download thumbnails. And as you'll see, they both popped up right there, no problem. And that is because now the file name matches with the database name, and it's just that simple. Well, what happens if you have a game that's not listed in the database at all? If you have a case where your game isn't in that database at all, you might have to get a little creative. Take a look at my PlayStation games here. As we go down the list, you'll notice that my Thrasher, Skate, and Destroy doesn't have a thumbnail. If I click on Download Thumbnails, nothing. Why is that? Well, let's take a look at the database. This time we want the Sony PlayStation, Boxart, and we go down to the T's for Thrasher, T-H-R, and right here we see there's T8 Threads of Fate. There's no Thrasher. Thrasher should be right here. So it's just one of those rare cases that it's not listed in the database at all. And if your game is in that situation, you're going to have to get a little creative and actually pull in an image from somewhere else. So I like to just go to Google and type in the game Thrasher, Skate, and Destroy and Boxart. And then we go to images here and find a good image. Now, this first one here actually looks really nice. I like that one. Yeah, this will do. So go ahead and just save your image. I'm going to save mine to the desktop to make things easy. Now, you're eventually going to want your image in a .png, a ping format. But do not change it right here or you will have problems with RetroArch. So go ahead and just save it as whatever type that the web wants to save it as. In this case, it's a JPEG, so I'm just going to save it. Go into my desktop now. This is where it's saved, right here. Right click it, open with Paint. Everybody has Paint, makes it easy. Now just go to File, Save As, and now right here under this drop down, this Save As type, click that, and now choose Ping, this .png right here. Click that, and then save it, and it'll save a copy of this as a Ping format right next to the other one. So you'll see right there, they both are. This first one was the JPEG. I don't need that anymore. I'm going to delete it. There we have that PNG. Like I said, do not try to change the .png when you're directly downloading it from the website, or you might have issues with RetroArch. So make sure to download it, save it first, go into a Paint program, and then change it to a ping. So we go back into RetroArch, come over to the desktop menu, show desktop menu, and right there's Thrasher. You'll notice in the bottom here, right here where it says Boxart, there's drop image here. All we have to do is drop our ping image right there, and boom. It's that simple. Now we have the Thrasher, Skate, and Destroy thumbnail ready to go, even though it wasn't in the database. So we'll just look at everything here, and there it is. It's beautiful. Look at that. So it's just that simple. You're able to add it if it was mislabeled, like with Super Mario, and you're able to add it if it wasn't in the database at all, like with Thrasher. So just a quick recap. Check in that database. Make sure the name of the RetroArch game matches up with the database name. Or if your game isn't listed in that database at all, go ahead and just pull in an outside image. Make sure you save it as a ping type and then just drag and drop in the desktop menu. And that's about all you have to do. Not that difficult. However, it is a little bit weird if you don't know what to do in the first place. But go ahead and like and subscribe. That'll help me out a ton if this helped you out today. And I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye-bye.